Hi. Good day, everyone. Today, I will be teaching you how to solve definite integral problems.
First, we need to know what definite integral means. By definition, it is defined to be exactly the limit and summation of the net area between a function and the x-axis. When we see an integral, the sign will look like this. And it has a lower limit and an upper limit. Let's say A will be the lower limit and B is the upper limit. Then the function f of x dx. This dx means that we will be solving for the vertical slip. When we look at a graph, it will look like this, for example. Let's say this will be the A, the lower limit, and this will be the upper limit. And the curve looks like this. From this limit, this is your limit. Between this limit is the area of your problem. And this is what we are trying to find when we are solving for definite integral. Now, before we go to our main problem, let's review some basic of definite integral first. Let's say we have integral of from 0 to 2, then a function of x to 3, dx. Now, when we find the antiderivative of a function, it is x to the power of n to x to the power of n plus 1 over n plus 1. This process is the basic of having or getting the antiderivative of a function. So when we say we are trying to find x to the power of 2, then it will look like this. X to the power of 2, then plus 1 over the 2 plus 1. Then the answer is x to the power of 3 over 3. So when we try to solve this function, the process will be like this. That's a x to the power of 3 plus 1 over 3 plus 1. So this x to the power of 4 over 4. And will be evaluated from 0 to 2. Put the lower limit 0 in the bottom and the 2 at the upper part. So this is your antiderivative of the function. Now let's move to the main problem of this video. The problem is find the area under the curve of the function f of x equals to the square root of x dx within 0 and 1. The problem of the definite integral looks like this. From 0 to 1, then the function square root of x dx. Now, most of the students get scared easily when they see a square root or a fraction because they always want a constant number, which is much easier. But if we know how to manipulate or simplify the given functions, it will be quite easy to solve. Now, when we graph this function, it will look like this. So, the center is 0, then 1. Then it has a curve. from the lower limit of 0 and the upper limit, which is 1. From this limit to this limit, here is your area. Now, we can solve this, or we can find this area, the value of this area, by solving the function, by getting the, by solving this function. Now, we all know that the equivalent value of a squared is 1/2. So, we can simplify it by having this. Integral of 0 to 1, the x, then change the squared sign into an exponent, which is 1/2. The value of the square root is 1/2. Then, dx. Now, let's try to get the antiderivative of this function based on what we reviewed earlier. So, x is equals to 1/2. Plus 1 over 1/2 plus 1. Now, x, then 1/2 plus 1 is equals to 3/2 over, what is 1/2 plus 1 is equivalent also to 3/2. So, the antiderivative will look like this. X to the power of 3/2 over 3/2, and was evaluated from 0 to 1. From 0 to 1. 1. Now, we can simplify this further by dividing this denominator from the constant numerator. We all know that it has an invisible constant here, which is 1, that looks like this. 1 over this denominator, 3/2. And this problem can be solved into 2/3. 2/3. So, the simplest form of this function is 2/3, then x to the power of 3/2, and it was evaluated from 0 to 1. Now, this is our simplified form of our function earlier. Now, we can get the value of the area by substituting this function from 1, then subtract from the function, then substituted by 0. It will look like this. 2/3, then substitute the 1, the x, and 3/2, subtract, copy the function, 2/3, but substitute the 0, 0, then 3/2. Now, let's put a bracket so that we can still distribute the sign to this area. But since the x value is 0, 0 to the power of 3/2 is 0, then 0 multiplied by 2/3 is equivalent to 0. So, just cancels out. Cancels out. Well, here, when we 1 to the power of 3/2 is equals to 1, then 1 multiplied by 2/3 is equals to 2/3. And since it is 0, the area of our problem is 2/3 unit squared. This is the final answer of our definite integral problem.